Do you ever feel like there are two versions of you constantly fighting in your head?
Good morning, sunshine. We're going to start with this lemon water, then we're going to do a 45-minute fasted workout, and then we're going to be rewarded with this beautiful green juice. Have you set your intentions today?
I mean, pizza has tomatoes, and french fries are made of potatoes, so you're pretty much just eating a salad.
But what if I told you that there's a way to quiet that self-sabotaging voice?
So buckle up, because today Dani learned all about GLP-1s and she's going to spill the tea. Okay, so what the hell are these GLP-1s everyone's talking about, and why are celebrities getting skinnier by the minute? GLP-1 stands for glucagon-like peptide. And these meds, in normal human speak, all they do is copy a hormone that your body already produces after you eat. This hormone's whole job is to tell your brain that you're full and also control your blood sugar. These meds were first created to treat diabetes, but then they realized that people are just losing a ton of weight on it, so they rushed to create a new version of them to be marketed and FDA approved for weight loss. You probably heard some of these names floating around, like Ozempic, Mounjaro, Zepbound, and Wegovy. They all pretty much work the same. You just inject them once a week and they control your hunger. Here's where it gets a little messy though. Remember when I told you that these medications were first created to treat diabetes? Okay, so when they created the new versions for weight loss, we ended up with all these medications that are pretty much the same thing, just a different name. For example, Ozempic and Wegovy. They're the same medication. It's called semaglutide. Ozempic is for diabetes and Wegovy is for weight loss. You hear more about Ozempic because that was the first medication that came out, so people used it off-label to treat obesity. Then you've got Mounjaro and Zepbound. They're the same medication called tirzepatide. Mounjaro is for diabetes and Zepbound is for weight loss. When I started my weight loss journey, I used Mounjaro because Zepbound wasn't around. Mounjaro and Zepbound are a little different than Ozempic and Wegovy because they hit a double target in your body, so that makes them more efficient.
Besides the GLP-1 hormone, they also hit the GIP hormone, which is another nutrient-stimulated hormone that regulates energy balance.
And if you stick around, you're going to see how to get Zepbound for a third of the price. Quick disclaimer, I'm obviously not a doctor. I'm just someone who tried the stuff and did her research. So please talk to your healthcare person before jumping into any meds, okay? And if you're enjoying this content, just make sure to like and subscribe so you can get more content like this. I'll be posting more videos about my Zepbound journey and also other interesting subjects. If you have any questions about my experience, just drop a comment down below. So how do these GLP-1 shots actually work? When you take a GLP-1, there are three main things that happen.
First, it makes your stomach empty slower,
so you're full for longer. Second, it talks to your brain and it pretty much says, we're not hungry right now. And third, it helps your body release just the right amount of insulin when your blood sugar goes up. So what does this sciencey stuff actually mean? You're not as hungry. And when you eat, you just stay full for longer. And that, my friends, is what brings the weight loss. But let's get real for a sec. These are not magic pens. They're more like training wheels for your appetite, and you still have to do the work. You still have to eat healthy and move your body. You're just not gonna feel that need to faceplant pizza every night. So when I took Mounjaro for the first time, it was the weirdest thing because I never noticed that I had this little voice in my head that would tell me to eat. And it's kind of like the voice from the beginning of the video. You don't notice it unless you can quiet it. So when I took Mounjaro, I would forget to eat, which never happened in my whole life. And before that, it was like I would have breakfast and I'm already thinking, what am I gonna have for lunch? Or like dinner, my whole day would just revolve around like, when is my next meal? And after Mounjaro, I would just plan these things and I would think about them when the time came. And it wasn't like I didn't enjoy eating, I enjoyed it, but I wasn't like obsessing about it. I believe it's gonna be the same with Zepbound. I haven't started yet, I'm still waiting for them to ship my first box, but it's the same medication, so I'm not expecting anything different. Results-wise, the first time I took Mounjaro, I was 200 pounds and I lost 40 pounds. and that was in around 8 months. The thing was that I was all over the place because there was a lot of shortages of the doses that I wanted, so I had to be going up and down, and that ultimately made me quit. In clinical trials, people lost 22.5% of their weight on Mounjaro and Zepbound. Now, people that took Ozempic and Wegovy lost around 15%. I think it's important to say that when I did Mounjaro, I was exercising, lightly, but exercising. I was eating healthy, and your results might be different than mine, so this is good for you to see what's possible, but you might lose more weight, you might lose less weight. It all depends on your body, what you're eating, and what you're doing. Now let's talk about how to actually get these medications. And yes, I'm gonna talk about cost and how to get discounts. So step one is getting a prescription. So that means that you have to talk to your doctor. They're gonna ask you about your health history, your weight struggles, and any other medical stuff that you got going on. Usually this medication is prescribed to people with a BMI over 30 or over 27 with other health concerns like high blood pressure. They're gonna ask you about your weight loss journey. How have you tried losing weight in the past? If you haven't tried diet and exercising yet, they might ask you to do that. They're also gonna ask you for some blood work, and if you've done it in the past, maybe like a few months, they might be able to use that. If you don't feel like going to the doctor in person, you can use one of the telehealth options out there. I personally use Plush Care. I am not getting paid to say this. I'm just a real patient. I'm gonna break down the cost and how it works in a bit. Just make sure that whatever telehealth option you use is legit and not some sketchy website. Now about the shots. I know that the needle thing is a little scary. I was a little scared at first. So the first one I used was the pen that was concealed. So you pretty much like you would pinch your stomach, you would put this pen, you would never see the needle. You just press it, it would go in, and then at some point it would go out. And it was so chill. This time I'm gonna use a regular syringe and I'm not worried at all. I don't really love needles. I used to faint when I got my blood drawn. So if I can do it, I'm sure you can do it. So when you start with these shots, you start at a baby dose. So for Zepbound, that's 2.5 milligrams. And then you work your way up. And that's so your body doesn't get all that stuff all at once. Like you start getting used to it. And before I get into pricing and how to get a discount on your prescription, let's talk about the side effects, because there are a couple of side effects. The most common ones are nausea, diarrhea, and constipation. Now, I need to have a cautionary tale here. I need to share a cautionary tale with you guys. That happened to me, and you don't want to go through that. So when I was on Mounjaro, I got pretty constipated, right? And I was getting a little worried, like it was days and I was super backed up. So I bought this like supplement that was supposed to be not a laxative, but like act kind of like a laxative. So I took it and I just sat down and I was like, okay, let's see what's gonna happen. Nothing happened, so I was getting worried. So then I just ordered a laxative.
It was at this moment that she knew she fucked up.
And it got delivered to my house, and I was like, okay, let's take this. It was the afternoon of this beautiful day. I had a party to go to, so I took that, and oh my God, it was the worst experience of my life. It was like a hurricane in my stomach. I was violently ill. I was like vomiting and going to the bathroom every 10 minutes, and yeah, so don't do that. So that day I had to cancel my party and I called a doctor because I couldn't even go to the hospital. Like I was really sick. So I called a doctor and I was like, I don't know what to do. Like I'm in the bathroom every 10 minutes. I think I'm gonna die. And they said that pretty much what happened was this medication, it delays your digestion. So when you take anything, it will take a while for it to act. So I took that first one and then I took the second one that was a strong laxative and it all acted at once and it prolonged that experience for me. So just don't do it. If you get constipated, talk to your doctor and see what's best.
Do not do that.
And this is also important to note because some people take birth controls, and with birth controls, it's the same thing. This will delay the absorption of your birth control depending on how you take it. It can make it less effective. So you have to think about these things. You know, if you take other medications, you have to tell that to your doctor before you start on a GLP-1. So besides this horror story, the other side effects that I felt were nausea whenever I had my first shot, and then whenever I upped my dose. If I overate, then I would feel a little nausea too, but mostly I was fine. Some people I know, they feel extreme nausea with this medication, so every person is different. For me, it was pretty chill, except for my horror story that happened once. After that, never again, and the nausea was okay. Like, I wasn't sick and bad or anything. I just felt a little sick. Then there's this thing called Ozempic face, and Ozempic face is when your face gets saggy and hollow. And that's really not related to the medication. It's just related to losing weight fast. And it could happen to you or it could not. It really depends from person to person. Now it's time to bust some myths. Only celebrities can get these. That is not true. And yeah, they're expensive, but I'm gonna break down the cost and how to get them for cheaper in a bit. And then the second myth is that's cheating. This one irritates me so much. This is a tool. It was created for weight loss. So if you're sick, use medication to get better. That's not cheating. If I have a headache and I use Advil, am I cheating? No. But haters will be haters. Now, these medications aren't right for everyone. If you're pregnant or you're trying to get pregnant, or if you have certain thyroid conditions, or if you have history in your family of certain thyroid conditions, this might not be for you and you have to look for something else. There are actually no confirmed cases of this medication causing thyroid cancer in humans, but when they were running the studies in mice, it did cause proliferation of C cells and tumors. But that does not always translate to the same in humans. All right, now let's get to the juicy part. Let's talk money. So these medications are not cheap. If you're getting them without insurance and without discounts, you're looking at anywhere between $900 to $1,400 a month. If you have insurance, just check with them because they might cover it. I know that they usually cover this for diabetes, but for weight loss, they're a little weird. But I do have some great insider tips on how to get discounts with or without insurance. My first tip is the manufacturer's savings card and programs.
If you have insurance coverage, Wegovy has a program where you can pay as little as $0 for up to 13 months of treatment. Now, for patients with commercial insurance that doesn't cover Wegovy, or for those who don't have insurance, you can pay as little as $4.99 a month. I left a link to the savings programs in the video description. You cannot get this discount if you're receiving government-sponsored healthcare coverage like Medicare or Medicaid. Now, Zepbound has similar deals. You can pay as little as $25 a month with their savings card if your insurance covers it. You also cannot get this discount if you're receiving government-sponsored healthcare. And if your insurance doesn't cover Zepbound, or if you don't have insurance, there is a way you can get it for $3.49 a month, and that's about a third of the regular price. To get that discount, all you need to do is use Zepbound's self-pay program through LillyDirect. You pay $349 a month for the initial dose of 2.5 milligrams, and all other doses are $4.99 a month. With this option, you will be getting the vial, not the concealed pen, but it's the same thing, just different packaging. I left a link to get these discounts in the video description.
Now, to get a prescription for these, I opted to use telehealth, and I use PlushCare, as I mentioned before, and it's $19.99 a month for the subscription, plus $129 per consultation.
Your insurance might cover the consultation, but for the purpose of this video, I'll do the math with the consultation price included.
You might need one consultation a month or less, depending on what your doctor requests. So you're looking at membership plus consultation plus Zepbound through LillyDirect. And if you're getting a consultation every month, which might not happen, it's gonna end up costing around $4.98 per month. And this is for the first dose, the 2.5 milligram. Once you move up from that dose, and if you're having a consultation every month, that's gonna be around $6.48. And just to be clear once again, I am not getting paid to talk about PlushCare here. I'm just a customer, and if you wanna use their service, you can drop a comment down below and I can share a code with you where you get 3 months for free. And that's around $60 value. Now, if you cannot afford this, you can still finance your prescriptions with care credit. I'm also not getting paid to talk about this. This is just something that I used in my life. So Care Credit is a wellness and health credit card. And I got it when my cat Wizard had a health scare and we had to just get a lot of exams and stuff. It was a lot of money spent on him. So yes, Wizard has a credit card. I was able to finance the payment for all his doctor visits, his bath visits. He's not a person, Denny. and also his exams and all that stuff. And I did some research and I saw that it could also finance prescription there. So the only catch on this is that Lilly Direct is not a partner pharmacy, so you wouldn't be able to buy the medication from Lilly Direct. You'd have to buy it from one of their associated pharmacies. And I think like Walgreens, Rite Aid, they have a bunch of options there on their website. So you'll be paying full price. But depending on how you finance, you might be able to pay less than what you would pay monthly for your prescription. Now be really careful about websites and med spas that are selling these things without doctor consultation. A lot of these places are sketchy and they're selling like these compounded versions that are not FDA approved. So are GLP-1s right for you? I don't know. I think that's between you and your doctor. I just hope that sharing my experience, you were able to have a clearer vision of what it's like to take these medications and also to see that it's possible to make them affordable. And remember that there's zero shame in using medical tools to improve your health, whether they're injections, surgery, medication, therapy. You know, what really matters is your quality of life and not how you got there. So don't listen to those comments. If this video was helpful, make sure to like. And if you have any questions, you can drop them in the comments. I cannot give medical advice, but I'm happy to share more about how this experience was like for me. And don't forget to subscribe for more videos where I break down complicated stuff into something that actually makes sense. And I'll definitely be posting more videos of my Zepbound journey here. Thanks for watching TDL, and I'll see you when I learn some new stuff.